welcome to our final concert of the year. So great to see all of you, and thank you for being here. We are going to start with our concert symphonic band combined, and we're going to do a piece that's kind of, I wanted to give you a little background on. It's a bit of a different opener. This one is called Ecossaise, the military band, and Ecossaise is an old school sort of dance. It is a dance. Ludwig van Beethoven was enamored with this in the 1800s, early 1800s, and this piece he wrote in about 1810, but he kept it from publication until after he died. It was published posthumously. So the thing I like about this Beethoven piece is that it's very cute and fun and bouncy. A lot of times when you think about Beethoven, you think about the lush, beautiful harmonies, and you think about the really aggressive stuff like da-da-da-da. This is nothing like that, and we hope you enjoy it. This is Ecossaise for Military Band.
This next piece is, it's just a pretty little song, but it's not just a pretty little piece. It also has a pretty little poem that goes with it. And I had no intentions really of reading the poem to you or putting it in the program, but we had a volunteer in the band that wanted to read it. So Brenda Baskin is gonna read the poem that goes with the piece we're playing, There Will Come Soft Rains.
Soft rains and the smell of the ground, and swallows circling with their shimmering sound, and frogs in the pools singing at night, and wild plum trees in tremulous white. Robins will wear their feathery fire, whistling their limbs on a low fence wire, and not one will know of the one, not one will care at last when it is done. Not one would mind, neither bird nor tree, if mankind perished utterly, and spring herself, when she woke at dawn, would scarcely know that we were gone.
There will come soft rains.
Oh.
We've been very lucky to have a student teacher this year. His name is Alec Richard, and he's been with us the entire year, both first semester and second semester. He's been helping us out with the orchestra. If you were at the orchestra concert, he conducted a piece with the a couple of pieces with the orchestra. He's been working with Jazz 2 and Jazz 3 bands, and he's been working with both third and fourth period. So it's my pleasure to welcome to the stage Alec Richard.
much. That piece was called Dance Carnival by Randall Standridge, and obviously it's a play on some of the fun, different, you know, styles and articulations, and of course the opposites of fast and slow together, and the really kind of a comedic sort of piece. So thank you so much. That was one of our pieces that we performed also at festival, and so is our next one. At our festival this year, we did earn superiors from all of our adjudicators, so we're very proud of our band and very proud of all the students, and thank you parents for encouraging them to practice to get to be able to do those things. So thank you so much. So we're doing this next piece called Redemption, and it's a really beautiful lyric piece that has kind of some commercial sounding chords to it. I think that you'll find that a lot of the music that Rosanna Galante writes is kind of got that commercial sound. So we hope you enjoy this piece called Redemption. Oh, by the way, this is a good one for this coming weekend because he wrote this in honor of his mother. So happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there a little early.
Thank you.
Okay, before we go to our final fun piece here of our portion of the concert, I do want to ask some students on stage to stand and be recognized, and that is going to be the seniors. Seniors, please stand and be seen. Extremely proud of these, the senior class and well, all of them, because coming out of the COVID years was not an easy thing for bands, for musicians in general. And, you know, these kids all stuck with it and they kept after it. And not only did they keep after it, they kept after it and kept exceeding and excelling expectations, exceeding expectations and excelling at what they do. So again, kudos to all of the supporters of these fine young musicians, and thank you for that continued support throughout, and I'm very proud of it. I have to say, during that last piece, I was looking back there and listening to some of the solos and realizing that some of those soloists that you heard were students of mine 6 years ago at Citrus Hills, when they were seventh graders, and now they're graduating. So talk about feeling old. But I'm really proud of them, so nice job, you guys. This next one's a fun one. In fact, it came back from actually a senior from Festival Winds that recommended that you guys should do that one again. There were a couple of pieces that we kind of had played before, either in seventh or eighth grade. Good music is good music. This one was a little tough when we were in eighth grade, and it's not as tough now, and it's a lot of fun either way. So we hope that you enjoy it. I do have something for you to do during the song, though. Okay, I'm gonna need your help. And it goes like this. All you have to do is copy me, and then I'll show you into stuff. I'll turn around, I'll even direct you. They don't have to watch me. But it goes like this. Everybody say this back to me. Ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka, ooga, ooga, ooga chaka. Okay, that's gonna be so important. Okay, you have a very important job here, and I'll show you where it's at. It's going to be kind of close to the beginning, a few minutes, a little bit into the song. I'll turn around and face you, and I'll probably have the mic on too. So here we go. Have fun. I'm counting on you. All right, here we go. Guardians of the Galaxy.
Ooga, 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 ooga,
Thank you very much. We will be back with you at Festival Winds in just a short moment. Thank you so much.
slight change in program. We're going to flip the last piece, the first piece. So the first piece we're going to play is Shine. And I usually wouldn't talk too much about a piece before we play it, but this is a programmatic piece. And it kind of tells a story. If you think of backwoods Appalachia, think of a pleasant car ride or truck ride by moonlight, okay? And this piece is called Shine.
Thank you.
Well, we're only doing three pieces tonight, but we put a lot of notes in those three pieces, or at least two pieces, the first two and the last two. These guys have been working incredibly hard on those two pieces. We had a great experience with our festival that was held here at Santiago High School. All three groups got unanimous superiors. This group not only got unanimous superiors, but every sub-caption was a superior and an A. So it's like they, knocking it out of the park just isn't underestimated. They really, really crushed it. And tonight we have a completely different set of music only a few weeks later. So these guys have been working really hard and they're just gobbling up difficult music. So super proud of them. Of course, I think you know that we had a little trip on our spring break, and this next piece is kind of inspired me being on the memorial, the USS Arizona Memorial, Pearl Harbor, and you know, these trips, the kids learn so much. They learn not just about music and performing for other people. This is a great, you know, history come to life lesson. But they learn all sorts of other lessons, how to deal with a group of people, how to manage money, just so many different things. Reflecting on that trip really made me think of this piece, and I think we've done it way in the past, but Mr. Marone put together a little video clip of the band on the USS Arizona Memorial. And at Pearl Harbor. And there's something really special about the band that was assigned to the USS Arizona. And I'm gonna ask Gracie to read the inscription that's at the beginning of the piece here for us.
U.S. Navy Band No. 22 held the unique distinction in that its members were formed together, trained together, and transferred together. In May of 1941, these Navy musicians were assigned to the USS Arizona at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii. On the morning of December 7th, 1941, all 21 members of the USS Arizona Band, ranging in age from 19 to 31, perished in the attack on Pearl Harbor. Elegy is a tribute to the lasting legacy of the members of the USS Arizona Band, entombed with over 1,100 other sailors in the sunken wreckage of the Arizona.
This is Elegy for the USS Arizona. Thank you. again, that video was compiled and put together by Mr. Marone, one of our chaperones on the trip. We're going to close our concert with a piece called Incantation of Dance. Before we do that, I'd just like to recognize all the seniors in the band. Can you guys stand up, all the seniors? Band, concert band, Symphonic Winds. Can you guys stand up too if you were here? Especially Kara Simmons. This year. One was called October. We played that earlier. I believe we played it for festival. The other one is this piece, Incantation and Dance. And the reason why we program these two pieces at different times of the year is really a tribute to our good friend Mike and Jenny, who passed away. This in his first year teaching here, he programmed these two pieces for festival. We just wanted to kind of have them with us as this year's seniors, the group that started with Mr. G, plays these two pieces, one for festival and then this one, Incantation Dance. Okay? Thank you for coming tonight. This is the Wind Ensemble, and it really is one of the best sounding ensembles that you'll hear in Southern California.
Thank you. Thank you.